Hi everyone, Joe here, and my Note 4 has finally received Android 6.0.1 Marshmallow, so let's take a look at what's new and whether you should update. Okay, so the first thing you'll wanna know is that the phone definitely feels snappier. I don't know if it's because of the animations or it's actually faster, but it certainly feels more responsive in everyday usage. Speaking of animations, they've added a whole lot of new ones, from the app opening to this new fade when you lock the device, which I'm quite a fan of. From a visual point of view, you'll also find new icons for all of the system apps, which are now identical to those found on the S7 and S7 Edge. The apps themselves, however, are just the same, which is a pity because I wouldn't have minded some upgrades to the camera app. The fonts have also been updated, resulting in a cleaner look overall. You'll also find a bolder font on the app switcher, which by the way also feels faster, and a bigger font in the clock on the lock screen. As for actual new features, you'll find all of the ones supported on stock Android Marshmallow, which you can find in more detail in the video linked below, but I'm also going to quickly explain them now. First of all, Doze is finally here. What it will do in practice is it will detect when your phone is idle, for example sitting on a desk not being used, and it will reduce by a lot its power consumption, extending your standby time quite a bit. Of course, this won't directly affect your screen on time, but it will help in a better life overall. Speaking of which, that also seems to have improved, and I'm finally seeing screen on times of 4.5 to 5 hours, but that may vary depending on your specific usage. Another interesting feature introduced with Marshmallow is Google Now on Tap, which you can activate by holding the home button. Basically, Google Search will scan text on whatever page you're into and will give you relevant information based on that screen, for example wiki pages or websites. And if you're always concerned about privacy and apps reading your info, you'll be happy to know that you can now set individual permissions to each app. So for example, you can grant access to a certain app to your camera, but deny it as for the storage. Finally, you'll also find a new and updated share menu, which also shows you the most recent contacts to quickly share content with them. Apart from these stock new features, you'll also find the Samsung One Screen Off Memo, which has been introduced on the Note 5 and allows you to take notes when the screen is off by simply extracting the S Pen and starting writing. The note will then be saved just like every other one when you put the S Pen back in. By the way, if you're interested in this feature you don't have Marshmallow yet, there's also a little workaround I've published a while ago, which you can also find in the description. Overall, I'm happy to say that this update is a no-brainer. The phone is faster, it lasts a bit longer, and you have some welcome new features which bring this device a bit closer to the latest Samsung generation. So that was it for this quick overview. Hope you guys found this video useful, and if you did, definitely don't forget to support the channel by hitting the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. As always, thank you so much for watching, this was Joe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.